Good morning, Garden Homes. This week we've been studying the story of Solomon building the temple, and we want to make an application to our lives. How are we builders? There was a man who was a master craftsman, a carpenter, his entire life, and he day after day built custom homes. He thought about retiring, and so he went to his boss and he said, "As soon as I finish this house, I'm going to retire." And his boss said, "I really would like for you to build me one more house." The carpenter thought about it, and as a favor to his lifelong boss, he said, I'll do it." And so he finished the house he was working on, and then he went about building the house that his boss had asked him to build. And after a while, he just lost heart. He didn't do his work like he had done in the previous homes that he had built over the years. The craftsmanship was poor. He used inferior materials. He cut corners. He finally did finish building the house, and he called his boss and said, I'm done now. It's time for me to retire." And the boss said, "Well, let me come on over. Let me see what you've done." So his boss met him at the house, and he handed him the keys. And he said to him, "Thank you for all of the work that you've done for me over the years. Here are the keys to this house. I'd like for you to have this as a gift." The builder was shocked. He didn't know what to say, because he knew that the house that he had just built was not of his best effort. It wasn't anything like the houses he had built through his entire career. What about us? What about the building that we do? What about the jobs that we do that our God has asked us to do? Today, we want to take a look at the story of Solomon, and we want to make a comparison. We want to apply. How do we serve as God's builders, just as Solomon did his job during his day building God's temple? How do we be kingdom builders? How do we testify to the nations? Let's continue by offering Luther's morning prayer. "I thank you, my Heavenly Father, through Jesus Christ, your dear Son, that you have kept me this night from all harm and danger. And I pray that you would keep me this day also from sin and every evil, that all my doings in life may please you. For into your hands I commend myself, my body and soul, and all things. Let your holy angel be with me, that the evil foe may have no power over me. Amen." Garden Homes, as we continue our devotion today, we'll be taking a look at an anthem, "What a Friend We Have in Jesus." Then we'll take a look at a short account of the story of this week, Solomon building the temple. And then we'll make the application. How do we serve as kingdom builders for our God? We'll continue with our anthem.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Try. so faithful. Who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden? Cumbered with the load of care.
In King David's time, the Ark of the Covenant, which was a great golden chest that held the Ten Commandments and represented God's presence among the Israelites, had been held captive by the Philistines. King David gathered all his soldiers and all the people of Israel to rescue the Ark of the Covenant from enemy hands. As they returned to Jerusalem, the great crowd of people danced with joy and sang songs of praise to God. Years after bringing the Ark of the Covenant back to Jerusalem, God gave King David peace from all his enemies. In awe of all the Lord had done for him, King David decided to build the Lord a temple. But because King David had been a man of war, God came to the prophet Nathan and told him that King David would not be the one to build this amazing temple. Instead, God said that King David's son Solomon would build him a temple, and that God would set up an eternal dynasty through the lineage of King David. As King David came to the end of his life, he made preparations for Solomon to build the temple. King David had great ships bring logs of cedar wood from foreign lands, and he had tons of stone carved from distant mountains brought to Jerusalem. He ordered iron and more bronze than could be weighed to make nails and other fittings for the great temple. King David gathered the leaders of Israel together and told them to support Solomon so he would be successful in this great task. For more than 7 years, Solomon embarked upon the great work of building the temple. When it was finished, it stood 4 stories tall and 9 feet long. The interior of the building was completely covered in cedar wood, decorated with beautiful carvings of fruit and open flowers. The walls of the inner sanctuary, the room where the Ark of the Covenant was housed, were covered in pure gold. Not a single surface of the temple was without decoration. It was a magnificent sight. When the temple was finished, Solomon completed his father's vision and had the Ark of the Covenant brought into the temple. As Solomon and the elders of Israel watched, a procession of priests carried the Ark into the temple. Once it had been placed upon the altar in the inner sanctuary, a great cloud appeared as the glory of the Lord filled the temple. The cloud was so thick, the priests could not perform their work. The entire assembly of Israel had gathered for the occasion. After seeing the glory of the Lord fill the temple, Solomon prayed to God, praising his glory and faithfulness. Solomon prayed that God's people would live according to God's word and purposes. Once Solomon had finished praying and blessing all those in attendance, the people celebrated the incredible feat that had been accomplished. The temple had been built, and the glory of the Lord filled the temple. Once the temple construction was completed, the Lord appeared to Solomon. The Lord said, "I have made this temple you built holy by putting my name on it forever." God told Solomon that if he followed him faithfully, as his father David had, his royal line would have no end. God challenged Solomon, as he instructs us all, to follow him faithfully.
Garden Homes, we just heard the wonderful story of how Solomon built God's temple. God wants us to be builders too. We might not build temples and we might not build houses, but God still has building work for us to do. He wants us to be builders in his kingdom. In Matthew chapter 6, verse 33, he says, "Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all these things will be given to you as well." God wants us to pursue his kingdom first. And he has suggestions for us that will help us to build his kingdom. I can find those suggestions in the Bible. We need to read the Bible daily. We need to find out what God's will for us in our lives is. And he tells us in the Bible. Number two, I need to communicate with my God. I need to pray to him each and every day. I need to pray to him often. I need to ask him for assistance. I need to ask him for strength and encouragement to go and to tell all people about his son Jesus and what he's done for us to save us from our sins. I need to regularly attend worship services. I need to confess my sins. I need to be strengthened by his word. I need to be encouraged by fellow Christians. I need to share my faith each and every day. For by sharing my faith, others will see the love of Jesus that is in my life, and I will give honor and glory to my Heavenly Father. You see, God is the builder. God gave Solomon the strength and the wisdom to do what he needed to do, and God gives us the ability to be builders in his kingdom. Through his word, he gives us specific directions. He gives us the words that we need to say to bring other people through the power of the Holy Spirit into his kingdom. It is my hope and it is my prayer that we are into our Bibles and that we are praying often and that we are attending worship regularly, and with God's power, we are able to share his faith every day and to be builders in his kingdom. Let's pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for all of the blessings that you give to us each and every day. And especially we thank you for sending your Son Jesus to be our Savior. We ask today that you would be with us as we continue to be builders in your kingdom. We ask that you would give us the courage and the strength to follow your great commission to go into all the world and to preach the good news. We ask this in your name. Amen. And now may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be and abide with us all. Amen. We'll close our chapel devotion today by offering the final anthem, "In Christ Alone."
Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are stilled, when striving cease. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. Of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. For every sin on him was laid, here in the death of Christ I lay. In the power of Christ I stand.